Do we have any teachers here? If you, I mean, we're not gonna climb all over you, but.
I teach adult education.
Good. And the teachers are saying.
I teach adult education.
Well, if that happens, how can we, you know, how can we get a good evaluation? Just hang a minute. You can hold on to your question one second. Just hang a minute. So, now we'll open this up to Q&A, and if you want to direct a question to a specific person up here, just say so.
So why is there this great fear of change from you? It sounds like they're trying to hold the teachers and the students more accountable, and I don't really see what harm it does in teaching to this test or having some things where in the past where teachers could just show movies and teachers could just pass the students for anything. Now we know when they graduate from high school that they can complete certain skills which have been decided are useful for them.
But that's been the case for the past, what, 10 years with the Connecticut Mastery Test, and it hasn't narrowed the achievement gap. The key to student success is having, I don't disagree with holding teachers accountable. What I think my problem with this is that what's right for one state is not necessarily right for the other state.
Where are you basing your percentages on and your feedback? You know, there's no educators here or feedback from the students that this is something that's so deleterious and harmful and such an outcry. It seems like it's a very small minority of people that are against any kind of government program or government intervention that are pushing their own political agenda to be against anything that has to do with change or anything that has to do with a government-funded program.
I'd like to say something if I could.
Bud, can I answer that?
Can I say something first, please?
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah.
I'm not an educator, I'm a regular person. And I went to school like everybody else and graduated, okay? I cannot tell you how many stores I've been into over the past 10 years with high school kids at the registers that cannot do basic math, cannot make change without the computer telling it. The computer says something for change and you give them something different than what the computer says, they are lost, completely lost. They have no clue how to do basic math. Now I'm sorry, as far as high school kids and they graduated, how do you not know that?
That's why they're trying to change it. That's
something we learned in grammar school. Are they not learning this anymore? The problem nowadays is they all have smartphones, they all have computers.
But that has,
learn the basics, then deal with the technology.
The title itself says the Common Core. They're trying to teach you those Common Core basics to do this. And so if you're happy with it staying like that, or then keep it that way, but they're trying to execute some change.
You're talking about how right now it's not working, then why don't you want to change it if it's not working out for you?
Okay, it's not working because they don't learn the basics anymore.
And isn't that what Common Core is about?
No.
It's Common Core.
No,
so Common Core is not about learning the basics.
It's pre-test, and that's what it teaches us.
Okay.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
You said about there's a lot of kids in your school that some of them can't pass this test and some of them can pass this test? Or have been passed.
The CMT.
CMTs, I think they're like really easy, and I know like my friend who's like got like a fourth grade reading level can usually pass.
Okay, good. He's a friend of yours, right?
You'd
like to see him achieve.
The fella.
Okay. Because Common Core is really social separation. You will not have that kid as a friend as you exceed. He will be deleted.
Okay. Unfortunately, that's the way it is. He's not as smart as me?
Yeah, but they won't even let you, your social is that you're gonna be separated. You'll even be going off to different areas.
Based on what?
Based on the scoring and the data.
What they've done with Common Core, one of the things is lowered the standards.
But then why is your daughter getting a D in math soon if they've lowered the standard?
Can I answer? Wait. You guys, you're two people.
There's no way of teaching this.
Excuse me. Two people in this room. If you want to dominate the entire conversation, that's unfair to everyone else. Okay, I'm just telling you.
Fair.
It's not fair. You asked a question when you first came into this room, and we know each other from Facebook. So I already know what your political ideology is, and you know mine. Let's just put the truth out on the table.
Okay.
I'm a very honest and direct person. That's why I'm running for Congress, because we don't have very many of them in Washington, D.C. But I can tell you something. A standard is something that is tested. Common Core is not. So please do not interrupt me. I will not interrupt you, okay? Standards are tested. Common Core is not. The results of Common Core are very self-evident. That's why people are pulling out of it as fast as possible. The concept that each child should be taught exactly the same is a failed concept, because each child is an individual, and that is why we are blessed with people who love to teach. Common Core, excuse me, I am speaking. The reason why we are blessed with teachers who want to teach and help students is to allow them to take their talents, their individual ability and gifts as teachers, and give them to our kids. Common Core prevents that. Why anyone would want that to happen to our kids is beyond me. But the damage that it's doing, to the point where kids are in counseling sessions, and since you haven't experienced that, and I as a parent have, I don't think it's very fair for you to come in here and not keep your mind open enough to take a look at the facts and what is actually happening in other areas of the country.
I'm very open-minded with it.
Couple things. If you completely ignore the fact that the federal government has taken over the education, which is unconstitutional, number one. Number two, they in this data mining, they have changed the student privacy laws. The information is personally identifiable by each student. Each student is identifiable in the data. That data is set up to a national database that the government has access to. It does not control it. The data is controlled by the National Governors Association and the CCSSO. Now, that data is open to the federal government. So what you have now is a national database of every child's behavior, home life, health, and over 400 individual data points on each child is collected and sent to the national level. If you're comfortable with that, I think you need to go back and read the Constitution. If you feel absolutely to have no fear of an Orwellian government, God bless you.
But what we're saying, essentially, is that this is a program that's bad for teachers, bad for students, and really bad for parents and grandparents. What we're looking for, obviously, is decent, good, sound education for our kids. We're not here to say, you know, you're a bad teacher or this is a bad administrator. We're here to say that there's something wrong with the basic system that they have to work with.
Is that right?
Yeah.
And people are doing the research to prove it. Now, if you don't believe it, take some of the paperwork that's back there. There's information from teachers, and they're upset, and they have reason to be upset.
I am for both directions. I think students should learn the good aspects of the United States as well as what had happened in history of the bad aspects of the United States. I am in full agreement, so we will never make that boo-boo again, okay? It's not that way with Common Core. And I have it right here to prove it to you.
I'm sorry, what isn't the Common Core is not teaching critical thinking, so they're—
No, it is. It's trying to teach critical thinking, but it's not going along with the natural development of a child's mind.
It's not age appropriate.
It's not—
it hasn't been tested.
Blind.
It has not been tested by psychologists and people that know how to develop curriculum. It wasn't developed by the people that would be able to put curriculum at age appropriate levels. So they're teaching What Common Core is, and I just want to explain one thing we haven't covered, is that it doesn't teach for all college degrees. It doesn't teach, it only focuses on specific careers. Now, if this curriculum that we're spending $16 billion on, $16 billion on, is going to focus everyone on specific careers, technology can change. And guess what? We're all going in one direction because it's common, that's the common direction. Instead of when children are young, we teach creativity out of them. When kids are young, your age and younger, much younger, 3, 4, 5 years old, the mind is so incredibly creative and wonderful, and we teach it out of them. And we make them and mold them into little people that we want them to be. Let me just finish. If you want creativity, innovation, discovery, science, you can't teach Common Core because it will teach it out of people.
Okay, and I would just like to add something else. And be honest with me, okay? And I'm not coming after you, okay? Because I know you're an intelligent girl. If you were taking a test, how would you like wearing a wristband to check your pulse to see if you're calm and you know an answer or if you get nervous? Would that make you uneasy?
It would kind of make me uneasy.
Okay, hold it. Clicking the mouse as you're doing, because it's going to be all on a computer, mm-hmm. does the very same thing if you make a mistake and it records. Okay, exactly what you're doing, and whether you're nervous or you breeze right through. Would that make you a little uneasy?
I guess so, but...
Okay, and how, and being, you're her father, I presume?
Yes.
Okay. How would you feel if they did, if they, I'm talking about the schools, okay, did an iris scan of your daughter? See that camera? It's an iris scan, literally an iris scan of your daughter's eye for identification. And they'll tell you it's for safety. That is more than...
Well, I don't have a problem with that, but I mean, that's fine. I mean, any of the stuff that you saw, I don't
All right, no, go. I'm serious, because this is what they are going to be doing. If you don't have a problem with it, okay. Well, they're already doing it in Washington State. They already did the iris scan in Florida. They already did it.
I guess my problem with it is I can understand that at this point some of the methods and things that they're going to be teaching haven't been tried, but it kind of seems like they are investing an awful lot of money in it, and it's maybe not wise to completely throw it out instead of making to look at some of the things that are good about it and how can they be modified.
What would you say would be,
should we just go back to the old way?
What's your vision? No, I feel every state should have its own sovereignty. I feel every school should have its own sovereignty. I feel, most importantly, you should have your own sovereignty.
Parents.
Okay, and the parents, well, that's, yeah, I'm sorry. The parents should have their own sovereignty. I also feel that it should be a well-rounded, enhanced education, but not the Common Core. I think you should have a say in it, as well as the school boards, and most importantly, the parents, and being known what's being taught.
What? Just a second, please.
Me?
Yes.
All right. As you guys know, me and Wally do a show on Metrocast. We had a couple guests from California probably 4 or 5 weeks ago, and the topic was Common Core, and they are microchipping these children, and that's what the big fight out there is going on. They even have a mascot called Chippy, and you can look it up online. And it's to ease the idea of putting microchips into the children. So when you're talking about the iris scan and the wristband, that's only to
look
that's only the beginning.
Well, I'm just wondering what the Common Core has, like, where if we show the Common Core, like, kids are automatically going to have microchips in their head.
Eventually you will, absolutely.
I apologize, actually, in all honesty, I did learn some things about this, and I appreciate your time, and I appreciate everybody being very civil. But I do have to go home and think about this a little bit.
Good night.
Thank you very much.
Good night.
I got to get everybody.
Oh, oh.
Well,